Hi, I'm the poor student. Today I'm going to show you how to cook a tuna steak in the toaster oven. Okay, so let's take a look at this tuna steak. All I've done to it is I've put it on this toaster oven pan. I've sprinkled Frank's hot sauce, a little bit of soy sauce, and cumin and black pepper. And that's been sitting there for about 5 minutes. And so now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take it into the smaller toaster oven right here. And I'm going to put it on the broil function, actually. On the broil function, that means the heat comes from the top only. So I'm just going to set it for broil function, about 350. And I'm going to try 10 minutes on each side to start. So let's come back in 10 minutes and see what it looks like. And then we'll probably flip it over at that point. Okay, so it's been 10 minutes and it just dinged, and so I'm just going to take this out of the toaster oven, and I'm going to put it on the counter right here. Okay, so as you can see, it's pretty well done. And so what you want to do now is, what I didn't tell you before, is that I actually hid a basil leaf underneath, and so that's supposed to, you know, infuse it with a bit more flavor. Now, if you look at it, it's pretty well done already. So what you want to do is, I'm going to put some basil leaves on the pan right there. And then I'm just going to use my chopsticks and flip it over and try not to break the fish. That might happen anyway, but here, I'm just going to put this down. All right. And use your chopsticks like this. All right, so you can see the underside is pink. Obviously, because the heat was just coming from up top. So I'm going to do this. But I'm not just going to put it in like that. I'm actually going to get some hot sauce. And I'm going to put more Frank's hot sauce on the top like that. Because you got to have flavor all over the place. And some black pepper. I'm going to skip the cumin just because I already had it on the other side. And I don't want to have too much cumin. So I'm just going to put some soy sauce as well. And that should be enough seasoning. Now it looks like, since it's already heated partially on this side, I'm just going to put it in the toaster oven for another 5 minutes. And that should be it. Alright, so let's go back. For only 5 minutes. See you in 5 minutes. Okay, so it just dinged right now, and I'm going to take it out. So hopefully this is ready. Alright, let's take a look at this thing. Alright. It looks pretty good, actually. It looks all cooked and everything. I'm just going to take a knife and cut into it and see how it is. Okay. So I got my knife here. Yeah, I'm just going to put this down again so I can use both hands. Okay. So, I'm just going to use a chopstick and a knife. And let's see. Oh, this is almost perfect. I guess you would call this a medium or something like that. It's just slightly pink on the side there. But I guess you need to cut in the middle to see what it really is like. Now the middle is probably going to be a little bit more raw, and that's exactly what I want, actually, because you want it to be kind of raw in the middle, and then cooked on the outside. So, this is how you cook a tuna steak in the toaster oven, and that's what it'll look like. So I'm just going to try part of the middle part, because I like the rawness of the tuna. So, there you go. Alright. Mmm. That is great. All you need maybe is a bit more Frank's hot sauce. And you got a perfect dinner. This is probably enough for two people. So you can, at the end, you can just wrap it up and put it in the fridge. If you can't eat it all. But this is really good. I'm the poor student, and This has been broiling a tuna steak in the toaster oven. See you next time.